Hello and welcome to my lightning talk, Tool Confusion, how to write Pyphonic code with Flakegate, Tox and Precommit. My name is Jürgen Moch, you can always reach out to me on Twitter. So imagine you wrote this super cool project and you want to release it to the world, but you also have a friend who is a Python developer and he says, oh no, you can't do this. This code is not Pyphonic. You need to lint your code and he recommends you to use Flakegate. But first, what is Pyphonic? Well, there are many definitions. I like the one by my friend Martin Farsen, and he says it's about using language idioms. And I think that's true, but also I think it's about following a style guide, and pip8 is the go-to style guide for Python. And there's a tool out there, Flakegate, which enforces this style guide. So, first you need to pip install Flakegate, but you shouldn't pip install Flakegate, otherwise you pollute your global side packages and maybe break your operating system. So you use a virtualenv, activate it, install Flakegate, run it, and the next day you have to do it all over because you don't find your virtualenv anymore. And this is how the result looks. Flakegate tells you everywhere where you have to modify your code and format it differently to make it more Pyphonic. There must be a better way, right? And there is one. You can run Flakegate in your IDE. For example, in Visual Studio Code, you just open the command palette, type linter, and you choose Flakegate and run it. This is great, but what about when you use a different IDE or what about your colleagues? Then you can use Tox. Tox is a virtualenv management and test command line tool. You define a Tox configuration file, list your environments, and not only the test environments, but also here for Flakegate. You create it, you install Flakegate, and you define a command to run Flakegate, and then finally you run tox-e Flakegate. This is great, except when you forget it, and you push to your central repository. Well, you need to run Flakegate also in CI to prevent this. Here, again, you install Flakegate, and you run Flakegate, and it's great. Except when you really forgot it to run it locally and it takes a couple of minutes until you get feedback from CI and maybe your whole team or your company gets an email because you messed up with a white space. This is not great. How can you prevent even committing a bad state? And you can use Precommit for this. Precommit is a linter runner. Here you also have a configuration file and this is in YAML format. And here's also a plus because you create here, here you define also the version. So every team member has the same version of the tool. You do a one-time pre-commit install and then every time you do a git commit, this triggers pre-commit and runs Flakegate and you never ever can commit a bad and unformatted code. This is great, but oh, now you have pre-commit, tox, your IDE, virtualenv, oh wow. What to do now? Okay, I have a solution. That's my solution. Maybe it's also a good solution for you. Let's have a look. First, let's update our tox-ini. Instead of installing Flakegate and running it directly, I install precommit and run precommit, because precommit is not only a precommit hook, but also a command line tool. Also, I define a GitHub action section and I tell it to run the linter configuration on Python 3.9. Then in GitHub Actions, instead of installing Flakegate, I just install tox and tox GitHub Actions and I run tox. Now we have the best of all worlds. We have clean configuration files. Everything is only defined once. There's a very low chance to forget running the linter and CI catches all bad commits. That's great. When you want to see this setup in action, you can have a look at either one of my repositories, Flask Reuploaded, or Haverbeam-pwned CLI. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Anthony Sotile and his many clones, because he not only maintains Flakegate, he wrote and maintains Precommit, and he also maintains Tox. So thank you, Anthony. Thank you also, Yuki Hattori, for creating this slide generator. Thank you for the pictures. Thank you for listening to me, and I wish you a great, great confidence. When you want, just reach out to me on Twitter, and see you later. Bye-bye.